As the world's first and only psychopathic Quran artist creating beautiful works of art to peacefully protest the online abuse of women by keyboard jihadis, my sculptures are highly collectible. Collectors are ready to pay endless trunks of money to own an original piece of D-Wood craftsmanship. But art has many enemies, my friends. A few days ago, I put an origami pig up for auction on eBay. The bid was up to $1,175 when eBay stopped the auction without warning. Why would eBay not allow me to sell this adorable origami pig? The reason is obvious, isn't it? eBay is racist against Japanese culture. Why else would the company oppose origami? But it gets worse. If you've been following the recent Twitter drama, this all started when a Dawa team announced an online campaign to harass and abuse women using veiled threats of torture and rape. I announced that I would respond peacefully with Quran artwork. But eBay won't let me. Is eBay for the online harassment and abuse of women? I was concerned about eBay's defense of online abusers, along with the company's overt racism against Japanese culture, so I contacted customer support about the takedown. Here's their response. Hello, David. Hi, eBay. Thank you so much for reaching out to eBay customer support in regards to your listing that was ended. Our policy team has reviewed the removal of this listing. Unfortunately, after the review, they have found that this item could be offensive to Muslims and won't be allowed on eBay. I apologize. I understand this is not the answer that you were hoping for. If you have any further questions or concerns, please feel free to reach out to eBay customer support. Thank you for choosing eBay. Have a wonderful day. So, my origami pig can't be auctioned on eBay because the item could be offensive to Muslims. That's an interesting policy. I'm going to contact them tomorrow to ask where their policy states that items that could be offensive to Muslims are not allowed on eBay. I'm also going to ask why there's no policy about items that could be offensive to Christians. For instance, check out some of these items that you can buy on eBay. Here's a t-shirt of a boot stomping on a crucifix. Here's a t-shirt with a picture of Jesus, but the face has been replaced with a skull. Here's a t-shirt that says, Save the Planet. How do you save the planet? By throwing your Bible in the trash. Here's a t-shirt that says, Satan sucks, Jesus swallows. Now, isn't that interesting? All of these t-shirts could be offensive to Christians, and yet eBay has no problem whatsoever with these items being sold on the site. If a Christian is offended by an item, how will eBay respond? They'll say, if you don't like it, don't buy it. This is the United States of America. If an atheist wants to make a shirt and sell that shirt to another atheist, it's none of your business. But if I want to sell my pro-women Japanese art on eBay, the company will stop me because my pro-women Japanese artwork could offend Muslims. Let's look at another example. You can buy a copy of the Hilali Khan translation of the Quran on eBay. I have the same Quran, just a different color. Mine is green. Let's look at a verse of this book that you can buy on eBay. Surah 98, verse 6. Verily, those who disbelieve in the religion of Islam, the Quran, and Prophet Muhammad, from among the people of the Scripture, Jews and Christians, and al-Mushrikun, those are idolaters, will abide in the fire of hell. They are the worst of creatures. Notice this verse in this book that you can buy on eBay calls Jews and Christians the worst of creatures. We're lower than pigs. We're even lower than an origami pig. Could Christians and Jews be offended by a book that calls us the worst of creatures? Yes. Does eBay care at all? Not a bit. Here's what's amazing. You can sell a book that calls Christians and Jews the worst of all creatures. eBay doesn't care who gets offended. But if I cut out the page that calls Jews and Christians the worst of creatures, and I fold it into a flower, eBay won't let me sell it because it might offend Muslims. You know I can't resist, right? That's how you turn a completely disgusting claim about Jews and Christians into a beautiful work of art. Sadly, even though you can purchase the completely disgusting claim about Jews and Christians on eBay, you can't purchase the beautiful work of art, because it's no longer Sharia compliant. There are some alternatives to eBay. How about we try out some of the alternatives and see how quickly they become Sharia compliant? I'll put this one-of-a-kind, screen-used flower made from one of the most disgusting and intolerant verses in the history of humanity on the online auction site eBid. The link is in the description box. Again, tomorrow I'll be contacting eBay to ask them to clarify their confusing policies. One of the good things about eBay is that it's much easier to get in touch with a representative than it is on sites like YouTube or Facebook. If you'd like to ask for clarification, you can do that through the eBay website or on Twitter. There's the Ask eBay Twitter page that's specifically for questions. You might have better luck on the Ask eBay page than I will on the website. If you find out anything, let me know in the comments section. In the meantime, an artist's work is never done. I'll talk to you again in my next origami lesson, where I'll continue showing Muhammad Hijab how to fold under pressure.